Okay, I'm going to walk you through my prompt template for telling a funny joke. And this is obviously a kind of a throwaway task, right? You don't necessarily need ChatGPT to write you funny jokes, but this tells you a lot about how to get good results from prompt engineering, even in situations where it's a little bit racier, right? It's the sort of thing that ChatGPT doesn't want you to come back with. First of all, let me just delete this, and then just going to ask it, say, tell me a joke. And it's going to come back with probably one of 25 jokes. Yeah, this here. Why don't scientists trust atoms? Because they make up everything. So that's a classic joke that ChatGPT tells. And you say, you can actually get it to give you a joke about a specific topic. It works kind of okay. Yeah, it's always really sad kind of dad jokes. Let me see. Now we're going to say like Joe Biden, sleepy. Whatever. And it usually is like pretty bad telling jokes about political figures because it doesn't want to upset anyone. Yeah, it's fine. In the style of Dave Chappelle. When you start getting it to replicate different comedians and stuff, it goes a little bit off the rails. And quite often it will come back and say that it's not like, you know, it's not allowed to say. It's not allowed to replicate this style, and yeah, it's okay, but it's a little bit problematic. Like, it tends to give disclaimers, but we're gonna paste in this and just see what we get back. Here we go. Tell me a joke about Joe Biden being sleepy, and I'm just gonna tell you why this prompt works. So you can see it's returning JSON, and that's what kind of makes this interesting. I'm giving examples. And I'm asking it to put the comedian name and then also the disclaimer. So it's giving a disclaimer to say, this is just emulating the comedian, right? It gets the reinforcement learning out of the way, like it lets it relax, basically, because it knows that it's shown a disclaimer, and then it can tell a much funnier joke after that, so without worrying about offending people. And it also then, because you put the comedian name in here, it also then doesn't complain about emulating someone else. And I've given just three examples, so Ricky Gervais, Robin Williams, and then I've also just in the prompt here, I just optimized that a little bit. But the key thing is the examples, and if you change these examples, if you make them shorter for the prompt examples you give, you'll get shorter jokes. If you make them racier, you get racier jokes. And because the disclaimer has a place to go, then you're going to get better responses. This, if we look at this joke here, the actual joke is, it starts here and ends here, and here we go. It talks about him being old. Yeah, I can imagine Dave Chappelle actually saying this. I think it's pretty good. He mentions the stoner on a Sunday. That's not something you normally get from ChatGPT without the disclaimers. You know, if you're using this in a system, you could then just pass the JSON and just get the joke back. But you could also just say, just give me the joke if you want, and it will come back with it afterwards. There you go. This is a pretty good trick in general for if you want to get rid of the disclaimers, or if you want to get around some of the limitations that ChatGPT either refuses or starts to complain about certain things, or add disclaimers to your prompts and make sure that you get the specific thing that you want, and let it feel free to do whatever task it is that you're trying to get done. So yeah, it's super interesting. You can actually get it to tell some pretty funny jokes if you try. And because you can give it a topic, you can use it to create a joke for any situation. If you're presenting at a conference, you can ask it for an opening joke on the topic. If you're presenting something to a client, you can ask it for what jokes you could tell for that type of client. I use this all the time just to make myself seem a little bit funnier than I actually am.